Subscapers, and welcome to Tugt's Kit Deal Quest Guide. The requirements are 50 construction, 45 strength, 43 crafting, and 40 mining. The items: 14 oak planks, rune pickaxe or better in your tool belt, melee armor, equip it, melee two-hand weapon for saving 3 inventory slots. That's why we are using two-handed weapons, ranged 2H weapon and ammo with it, bow or crossbow, so you can reach as far as possible to kill an enemy, magic 2H weapon and air runes, as well as water runes to be able to cast water spells. Make sure you are on the regular spellbook. Optionally, you could use the hybrid armor with a weapon that you can change the combat style, like the Sun Spear from River of Blood or Vanquish from the Maze Quest Caravan, and have as many free inventory slots as possible. The recommendations are food if you are low combat level, but take only one or two for now. Keep the rest in your bank. A charged Togulso ring from the Elder Kiln quest, or a lodestone to Karamjab, Varrok teleport tablet or lodestone to Varrok, and quick teleport charges. The enemies are between level 53 to 64. Let's go! To start off, the fastest way would be to teleport with the Togulso ring to the main plaza, or use the fairy ring code BLP, or use the lodestone to Karamja and run to the quest start location by going through the Karamja volcano, which I am doing. The quest start location is on the eastern side of the Char place. You can also see it on your minimap as the quest start icon. Talk to any of the three guards. Option 1, accept the quest. Head south and slightly west a little bit. To your south, talk to Char Ket Krol, option 1. Make your way to the northwestern part of this place. You could also use the Togulso ring to main plaza and run to the northwestern part. Enter the tunnel. Talk to Char May Lor, option 1. After the chat, use the Varrock Teleport or Varrock Lodestone and run north to the Varrock Library. Talk to Reldo. Option 2, option 3. Make sure you have at least one free inventory slot and search the middle bookcase in the southwestern corner. Read the Char Tourist Guide. Go through both chat options 1 and 2. Read the stone tablet as well. Make your way back to the Char place by using the Tokuloso ring or fairy ring code BLP or lodestone to Karamja and run to the volcano. Head towards the southeastern corner and along the way talk to the NPC which you talked to earlier. Talk to Char Get Kroll, option 1, option 5, option 5, option 4. Go east, talk to Char Get Rock, option 1. East, enter the mine. East of the lava, talk to Char Hör Precht. Option 2. Option 1. Talk to Precht again, option 2. Option 3. West of the lava, talk to Char Hör Klag. Option 3. Option 2. Option 4. North of you, talk to Char Hör Kol. Option 3. Option 2. Option 4. Southeast of the lava, talk to Char Xil Mor. Option 3. Option 1. East of the lava, tak du char hör prickt. Option 1. Option 1. South, tak du char xil mor. Option 3. Option 2. East of the lava, tak du char hör prickt. Option 3. Southwest of the lava, tak du char ket jok. Option 1. Option 3. Option 2. Option 3. Option 2. Option 4. Southeast of the lava, tak du char xil mor. Option 1. Option 1. Option 2. Option 4. West of the lava, tak du char hör klag. Option 1. Option 4. Option 2. Option 3. Option 1. Option 4. North of you, tak du char mei kol. Option 1. Option 2. Option 3. Option 4. East of the lava, tak du char hör prickt. Option 2. We're done with talking for now. From your inventory, get rid of the books from the Varrock library as well as the stone tablet. They are not needed, and we need as much free inventory slots as possible. West of the lava, mine the stone wall and fill up your inventory all the way to the max with the obsidian stuff you get from the wall. Craft them all into pillars by spam clicking the last obsidian slab in your inventory. Go southwest through the cave entrance. Go north to the quest start location. Tak du char hör frock to get your oak planks traded. Option 1 twice, and you can make more in the future if you need more. Head south next and go through the cave entrance. Push the Rock. North of You, Use a Plank on The Broken Wall. The hitboxes are kinda messed up, so it might take a couple of tries. Do not do anything yourself ahead of me, or you might get stuck. Follow the path to east. Stand south of the first broken wall you see. South of the wall, use a pillar to the wall. Use a treated plank to the cave-in south of you. Stand west of the cave-in and use a pillar to it. Use a pillar to the cave-in north of you. Use a treated plank to the wall west of you. And finally, use a pillar to the cave-in, which is the remaining one. Go north to pass the cracked wall. We will get some more planks and pillars. Head east, back to the obsidian wall. For the upcoming second and third cave, we will need 8 treated planks and 13 pillars in total. I'll get back to you after we have all of the remaining materials. I'm back. Head back to the caves, so it is southwest, and craft your pillars. Go east to the second cave. put on a staff and use any water spell to kill the enemy. Use a treated plank to the cave in. Head south, use a treated plank to the most southern wall. West wall, stand north of it and use a pillar to it. Eastern wall, stand north of it and use a pillar to it. Go north and jump over the rocks. Head east and use a pillar to the cave in while you are standing east of it. Stand east of the wall and use a treated plank to it. Stand west of the northeastern wall and use a pillar to it. Use a pillar to the leftover southwestern cave-in and use a pillar to the other one. Mine the collapsed wall and it is time for the last cave. Make sure you have 2 treated planks and 7 pillars. If you don't, you need to get those. This is the trickiest room. Go north, put on water spells and a staff, kill the fire monster. Put on the crossbow and ammunition to kill the other one. Try to jump over the stepping stones. After the cutscene, head south. Head all the way to the most southern part. Stand east of the southern wall and use a pillar to it. Stand north of the other wall and use a pillar to it. Jump over the northern cave-in. Continue north and kill the enemy with a crossbow. Stand south of the wall and use a pillar to it. Continue southwest, stand north of the wall and use a pillar to it. continue north, use a treated plank to the cave-in. Stand south of the close by wall and use a pillar to it. Return to the starting place, and after you jump over the cave-in, stand south of it and use a pillar to it. When you get close to the entrance, stand east of the wall and use a pillar to it. Use the jumping stones a little bit northwest. Head west and go through the cave entrance. Head west, right click and talk to Char Hur. Option 1. If you are low level, you can head south, visit a bank, get some food, but if you are high level, you will need no food at all. When you are ready, go north through the cave entrance, option 1. Do not pray against anything until the shell of the enemy is broken down. Use a melee weapon so your pickaxe from the tool belt will get used. And after you see it in your chat box, you can protect against melee and use any combat style. After the enemy is dead, return through the cave entrance. Go south and use the cave entrance. Talk to Char Hur Frog. Congratulations. You can get rid of the remaining pillars or treated planks. Remember to leave a like, comment and subscribe.